y corrientes, dejaste tu nombre en el mar, volteaste la cara sonriente, y yo que no supe nada.
From newsounds.org and from the Green Space, WNYC's live ground floor performance venue, this is Soundcheck, our podcast series of live performances and interviews. I'm John Schaefer, thrilled to have with us here in the Green Space today the Mexican singer, songwriter, and musician Silvana Estrada. She has a forthcoming album called Marchito, which is full of sounds of an emerging but already very distinctive musical voice. She grew up in the Mexican state of Veracruz, hearing the sounds of son jarocho music, but also as a teenager sang jazz, and through it all has developed her own approach to singing and songwriting. And we're going to get a chance to hear some of her performances right here on the stage of the Green Space, beginning with this song called Tristeza.
Tristeza, pregunto, ¿cuánto más hay que esperar para que entiendas que yo canto por llorar? Te pido un suspiro que me alivie el verbo amar y un beso prudente que me salve de extrañar aquel que ya no está. Ay, ay, ay. Y tú que no te vas, te pido una vez más. Tristeza, déjame en paz. Yo nunca me acuerdo cuántos besos hay que dar para que el viento se reviente por bailar. Si un día yo el amor me iba a salvar. Tristeza, te pido, no me cambies la verdad de aquel que ya no está. Ay, ay, ay. Y tú que no te vas. Te pido una vez más. Tristeza, déjame en paz. Tristeza, déjame en paz. Tristeza, déjame en paz. Tristeza, déjame en paz.
That is Silvana Estrada live in the Green Space, WNYC's ground floor performance venue, and a song called Tristeza. Just Silvana singing and playing the cuatro.
Yes.
Mexican musician on a New York stage playing a Venezuelan instrument. Now, I mentioned in the introduction, Silvana, you're from Veracruz.
Yes, I'm from Veracruz.
Which has this very distinctive musical tradition, the son jarocho music. And it has an instrument that kind of looks like that, the requinto. We've actually seen these instruments in the studio before. How did you end up with a Venezuelan instrument?
It's, well, it's really a curious kind of story. At that
time when I really wanted to start like creating my own music, I was actually playing the piano. I was, as you mentioned, I was studying jazz at the conservatory, and I was really trying to make songs. And, you know, it was so much theory, like harmonically hard for me. And I was really like trying to compose, but then I was thinking of all these chords and progressions, and suddenly I thought like, well, I grew up playing the jarana and the requinto, right? So why I don't use the jarana or the requinto? And so I started to play some chords, and everything was like son jarocho. I only could like sing son jarocho songs, and every time that I was composing with the jarana, I was composing in a son jarocho, really traditional, strict kind of style.
Because the instrument pushed you in that direction.
Yeah, exactly. And suddenly, like, I don't know, at some point, I went to my dad's studio and, you know, I just grabbed this cuatro and, you know, it was like, I saw like my parents singing songs with the cuatro like all my life because they really like Venezuelan music. And at some point I was like, well, I actually never played this. So I started to play this instrument and, you know, everything was so new. Like all the sounds, like I didn't knew at that time what I was doing with the chords and with my fingers, you know?
Yeah, yeah.
So everything was like so new, even if I know that I'm playing like three chords kind of songs, you know, really, really simple. At that moment I was like, this must be like a new chord. You know?
Because it feels like a new chord under
it
your
feels
fingers.
For
it's
me.
Not yeah. That's the reason that so many acoustic guitarists retune their guitars to open tunings. It's a way of just making yourself think differently about an instrument you're super familiar with. So this cuatro was made by your dad.
Yes.
Both of your parents are instrument makers. They're luthiers.
Yes, they're luthiers. Like my dad, he does like double basses and cellos, and my mom, she does violins and violas. But their atelier is like they work together.
Right. So there was obviously then music in the house.
Yeah.
With violins and cellos, was there a lot of classical music in the house as well?
Yes. Yes, and like my parents, they did like a huge like effort like to make me like a violin player. And I was like 8 years or 9 years, and I was like, I've been playing this like for 5 years and this still sounds like horrible. So I'm not doing this for the rest of my life. So I changed, like I played also viola, and at some point, and of course it was a lot of pressure because my mom, she did a violin for me, and then my dad, he did like a double bass for me, and I was like, stop, I don't want this, I don't want to play this.
So how aware were you, you know, in this kind of musical bubble of all these string instruments, of all the other styles of music that were out there? I mean, when did you discover jazz, for example?
Well, I feel really like grateful because in my family there was a lot of classical music, but also a lot of mini music, like in general. And I remember once I discovered, like, I don't know, in the CDs at my house, this beautiful album, like Billie Holiday's album, and I feel like I went crazy about her. Mm-hmm. And then, like, you know, because I didn't realize that all that music was a whole thing, because I grew up, I don't know, hearing to Miles Davis kind of blue, or or John Coltrane or Chet Baker. And for me, it was like something that feels great, but I didn't knew exactly what it was. And when I heard for the first time Billie Holiday, I thought like, whoa, this is a whole thing. This is a whole universe where you can actually be free at expressing yourself with music and reminds me a lot of the folkloric music.
Well, it's interesting you say that, because in Tristeza, the song that you just sang, there's a lot of, I don't know if you have the same word in Spanish, a lot of melisma.
Melisma, yeah.
Yeah, a lot of melismatic singing there.
Yeah.
Which, you know, kind of sounds like, that could come from anywhere. It could be a, you know, classical soprano doing trills, or a jazz singer, you know, having some fun with a word, you know.
Yeah.
But it also sort of reminds me of that son jarocho sound as well, you know, that típico, you know, almost crying sound that happens. So it's really interesting to hear that in your singing, knowing what your background is, and it's like, well, which thread did that come from, you know?
Yeah, it's really like, for me, it's really like, just open, like, let my heart, I guess, or let my imagination open, and suddenly I discover myself singing and thinking a lot of tradition, but then I'm thinking a lot of phrases that I learned while I was studying jazz, or sometimes I don't even think in anything.
So you have a new record coming called Marchito, and this will be your official debut, although, you know, there have been songs out there before. We'll get to hear a song from you in a couple of minutes that has like 30 million views for the videos that are online of it. But you want to play the title track from Marchito for us?
Yes, of course.
What does this word mean?
Marchita is to withered.
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 Okay.
You know, when a flower withered.
Right.
Yeah. So it was like really, well, I should play this song and then we can talk about the song.
Silvana Estrada is my guest on this edition of Soundcheck, our podcast series of live performances and interviews. And today we are on stage at the Green Space. Here's the title track from the forthcoming record, Marchita.
Del reencuentro de tu piel contra mi piel, me has costado tanto y tanto que ya mi alma se marchita y se deshace en lagrimitas que se olvidaron de rezar. Y si yo hubiera sabido que para ti era tan poco, hubiera sido más prudente al entregarte el corazón. Y si yo hubiera sabido que para ti todo era un juego, aquel verano entre tus besos no hubiera escrito esta canción. A poco voy perdiendo la claridad de tu retrato, pero no olvido ni un segundo el dulce tacto de tus manos. Ah,
sabido que para ti todo era un juego. Aquel verano entre tus besos, no hubieras querido esta canción.
That is Marchita, which is the title track of Silvana Estrada's forthcoming debut album, but a live performance here at the Green Space. We are streaming live in addition to recording this for our Soundcheck podcast series, available wherever you get your podcasts. And so, Silvana, there are people watching and writing in, and someone is asking when you will be back performing in Mexico City. I know you just played there in December, but...
Yeah. No, well, actually, I've been without playing in Mexico City for a while because of the COVID. Probably. The second, lo voy a decir en español because probably this person speaks Spanish.
Probably.
Seguramente voy a hacer un show la segunda mitad del año. Segurísimo, lo prometo. I promise. La segunda mitad del año. Ahí voy a estar. That's that.
All right. Now, here in New York, you will be playing at the Music Hall of Williamsburg.
Yes.
On Monday, February 21st.
Yes.
And that'll be... What kind of a band do you travel with?
Well, for this tour, I'm traveling with my trio, with Roberto Verasti. It's a amazing piano player. And for... In this project, he's also playing the vibraphone and the keyboard, mm-hmm. and also he's like singing some vocal backgrounds.
Okay.
And then I have a percussionist, Alex Lozano, and he's also singing, and me with the cuatro. And it's really like, you know, it's really like intimate kind of show.
Yeah, and a lot of these songs are intimate, and a lot of them have a sense of melancholy to
yes.
them. If you were Brazilian instead of Mexican, I would say they have that saudade
yeah.
feeling, you know?
Yeah, yeah.
Is that something that you come to naturally? Is that something that you find in, I don't know, in Son Jarocho music in Veracruz?
Yeah, well, I feel like in general, in Mexico, we have this beautiful connection with, for example, death or sadness or, you know...
Loss. Especially lost love, it seems.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And, you know, I grew up and I really like hearing to Chavela Vargas or José Alfredo Jiménez or, you know, people who can't speak to the sadness or to the loss of a love and can actually make some beauty about that, even mm-hmm. if it's so rough. And I feel really connected with that. And for me, it's really natural to speak about my feelings because sometimes I really need to create music in order to understand what I'm feeling. It's mm-hmm. like a necessity that I have, and really, you know, for me, songs are like this way that I have, and especially these ones, songs that I'm singing today, because they're like in the Marchita album, and this album is all about just an introspective kind of journey to understand the feelings that we have after a breakup. That's like the concept for me of this album.
Right. Okay. So the breakup album is not the province of American songwriters like, you know, Bob Dylan, Blood on the Tracks or whatever. Fine. People break up everywhere.
Yeah.
You can make a breakup album in any country, in any language. One of the other people watching our live stream, Bess, I think, asks, how did you find such an organic way of combining the sort of son jarocho sounds with the elements of jazz that you've studied?
I guess it's about let you, like, let you feel lost time to time. I learn every time that I don't know something, that I don't know how to do something. It's the time where I learned the most and the time where I need to let myself to be free as I can be. And that's something that I really try it every time that I was like making my own songs, and I was like, oh, I want to do all these things. I want to do like this type of singing, but then I want to do like this other type of folkloric singing. And, you know, at that moment, I just play. I think I need to have fun. It has to be something that I enjoy, and then whatever feels better, that's the way you have to choose every time. For me, that's my process.
Another listener slash viewer, Terry, wonders if you have ever heard Portuguese fado music and have any kind of connection to that.
Yes, of course. I love fado. I love it. I grew up hearing to, hombre, esta chica. I don't remember the name of this amazing woman, but the...
Amalia,
yes, yeah. yes. I loved her. I mean, I still love her. And
everybody loves
her. Yeah. yeah.
She's the Frank Sinatra and Enrico Caruso of
Fado. yeah, definitely.
Yeah, but that sort of that tristesse, that sadness,
yes.
You know, that's all, you know, that's deep in the soul of that fado music. So
yes.
I think that listener was onto something, that, you know,
yes.
There's definitely a kind of emotional connection.
Yeah,
there.
I can see the connection. And you know, that tristesse that you were talking about, you can find it in a lot of folkloric music all around the world. It's like almost like a crying of humanity, you know.
Well, it's the blues, right?
Yeah, it's the blues. Yeah,
absolutely. Now you've, you know, your career, you're still in your early 20s.
Yeah.
So people might think, wow, you're having this meteoric rise. You know, you play sold out shows and you're coming to big halls in New York. You've been at this a long time, though, haven't you?
Yes. I mean, you know, I've been singing for years, like since, I don't know, I had 12 or even 10, I don't know. But for like doing this, like doing, for example, interviews or concerts, I've been doing it for like 4 or 5 years. It's not that long.
Yeah.
But you know, even if my parents are musicians and I grew up surrounded by music, this thing about, you know, doing interviews and actually having concerts where people sing what I'm singing is so new to me every time. It's like, what I'm doing?
Well, you know, it must be, it's one thing to write songs and perform them for people. It's another thing when someone says to you, what's that song? What does that mean? What's it about? You know, and then suddenly you have to almost look back at the earlier you who wrote that song and figure out what you were doing.
Yeah, Yeah, that's so interesting. That's like, the other day I was thinking like, oh my God, I'm so afraid of actually telling a story that is not true because I'm not able to remember the real story of a song. That happens really often.
Are your parents really musicians? Yeah. Did your dad really build that
No,
cuatro?
That part of the story is so easy. But like, if someone asked like, what you were thinking when you did this, I was like, like, honestly, sometimes I don't know. I have the feeling, but like, I wish I could travel just to have the truth.
Well, a lot of people have certainly responded to the next song you're going to do, Te Guardo. There are a couple of different videos of this. There's one with like tens of millions of views, and then there's this lovely one that you did in Mexico City. It's outdoors. There's a dog barking through most of it. And I think that you can hear rain falling and birds. I mean, it's just wonderful, you know?
Thank you so much.
I mean, I'm as happy as anybody to hear a nice, clean recording of musicians in a studio without any distraction. But there was something about that performance, and you must have liked it too, because you released
it. Really liked it. Yeah.
So, I mean, this the title, Te Guardo, it's the full line is, I keep faith in, a little faith in you, right?
Yeah.
So is this, it doesn't sound quite like a breakup song.
Yeah. It's like, you know, Te Guardo, it's like, it's not even a breakup song. It's I guess it's a song about connections. Mm-hmm. It's like, I keep faith in you. Like, it's that song is so weird because I did it when I was just in love. But like predicting the breakup, you know?
Mm,
it was, yeah. So it's a song, like, it's mostly like an opening song. It's like, okay, I don't know what's going on, but if this ends like in the wrong way, then I'm going to keep a little bit of faith in you because maybe in a couple of years, then I can see you and just love you again.
Well, you know, you mentioned communication. This is a song that has obviously communicated with many people.
Yeah.
So, shall we hear it?
Yes.
Te Guardo is the song. My guest is Silvana Estrada on stage at the Green Space.
Tres caras posibles, tú me las quitas todas. Tengo una risa con alas que vuela si estamos a solas. Tengo una voz y una piel que quieren que tú las descifres. Tengo la vida muy corta para entender lo que dicen tus ojos que cuando los miro brillan igual que los míos, pero no logro entender de qué van. Pero si un día tú me encuentras y ahora piensas diferente, te guardo un poquito de fe para abrir los ojos y verte. Pero si un día tú me encuentras y ahora piensas diferente, te guardo mi luz de mañana, mis ojos, mi amor y mi almohada. Besos pendientes, uno por cada mejilla y un abismo de cristal por cada herida. Tengo el espacio carente que ocuparía tu abrazo si se nos
si era el caso de vernos lejos de la gente. Tengo la vida muy corta y tú la mirada decente, y a mí no me importa pensar lo imposible de tenerte. Pero si un día tú me encuentras y ahora piensas diferente, te guardo un poquito de fe para abrir los ojos y verte. Pero si un día tú me encuentras y ahora piensas diferente, te guardo mi luz de mañana, mis ojos, mi amor y mi almohada. Ah, 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 ah. Tengo dos besos pendientes, uno por cada mejilla y un abismo de cristal por cada herida.
Silvana Estrada, live with a song called Te Guardo, singing and playing the cuatro. It's a beautiful song. I mean, I don't speak enough Spanish to be able to know what the song is about, and yet I somehow feel like I know what the song is about.
Yeah. Thank you so much.
Here's a question that we're getting sort of variations on from several people who are watching, and it boils down basically to this. Do you have any tips for people who want to write their own songs?
That's a lovely question.
But almost impossible to answer, I would think.
Yeah. I mean, it's lovely that they think that I could actually have like a tip for them. I thank you for expecting that from me. I don't know if I have one. I still reading this How to Write One Song, this Jeff Tweedy's book. Do you know this
Jeff
book?
Jeff Tweedy's book? Yeah.
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 Just searching for that same question.
Yeah.
But I guess one tip is just to try, like, every day, and to read a lot of poetry. Sometimes we just focus like in just songs, but mm-hmm. songs is like the perfect mix of like poetry and music. So sometimes if you just develop like your musicality, trying to sing without any words, trying to find beautiful melodies without any words, and if those melodies actually tell something to you, then you're developing something really, really, really important when you're creating a song. And if you're writing a poem and actually moves you, then you're also developing something really important. And if you can mix those parts, then you will have, I don't know if a good or a bad song, but it will be like an honest song and a meaningful song, at least for you.
Yeah. Has that happened for you where you've discovered a melody and it just suggested words, or at least a story?
Yeah, a lot. But for me, mostly it's the other way. Sometimes I have like this idea or this group of words, not even a phrase, and I love them so much and moved me so much. And then I discovered a melody that actually can tell those words. Even if I'm not telling those words, you know, it's like this translation of what I want to say, but through the music.
Yeah.
And then the other way, it's that way for me.
Have you written most or all of your songs on the cuatro? Do you write on the guitar or the piano?
I also write I started on the quarantine to write in the guitar and also in the piano. And but the only song that I released where I'm playing actually the guitar is this song, Si Me Matan. It's, you know, a song about how hard it is to be a woman in Mexico, because it's so violent and it's so dangerous just to be a woman. And I did this song, and it was so important to me to do it in the guitar, because, you know, guitar has this, for me, the guitar have this sound so related to, how to say this, politic songs, or, you know.
Right. Protest songs, protest folk songs.
Yeah. That's so right. I'm so grateful for the guitar, because that sound gave me like the idea of this song.
And you've worked with Rodrigo y Gabriela, right?
Yes.
The duo guitar team.
Yes.
Two amazing guitarists. And, you know, I'm happy that at this point in their career, nobody points at Gabriela and says, wow, a woman playing a guitar.
Yeah.
You know, she and other people like her have made that normal now.
Yeah.
So you're doing the same with the cuatro, I suppose.
Yeah. Yeah, well, yeah, it's a, I just, you know, it's so, I'm so in love with this instrument, really. It's just gave me so much of my happiness the happiness that I have now and the work that I do now, it's because of this instrument. So I'm really grateful for Venezuela and Colombia, you know, the countries who actually invented this instrument. So I'm really in love with the sound.
For folks who don't know, there is also a Puerto Rican cuatro, and that is just a crazy instrument, because it doesn't... Cuatro should have four strings, but it has 10.
Yeah, why not?
Have you ever played that one?
No, never.
Yeah, it's got to be a completely different thing. Music Hall of Williamsburg on February 21st with your trio.
Yes.
The album, Marchita, comes out on Friday the 21st. Silvana Estrada is my guest and has been performing for us here on stage at the Green Space. Silvana, it's been a real pleasure hearing you in this setting today. Thank you so much.
My pleasure. Thank you so much. I'm really happy here talking with you.
And that'll do it for this edition of the Soundcheck podcast. I'd like to thank our usual crew, our technical director, Irene Trudell, and producer, Karen Havlick, but also the crew here at the Green Space, headed by Jennifer Sendro, Ricardo Fernandez behind the soundboard, David McLean handling the cameras. I'm John Schaefer. Thank you for being with us. You can find all of our Soundcheck podcasts at newsounds.org.